Hey everyone, I'm Rick Beato on today's Everything Music. It's What Makes This Song Great, episode 54. The band is U2 and the song is In God's Country, coming up next. In God's Country was the second song on side two of The Joshua Tree, which was released on March 9th, 1987. The Joshua Tree was U2's fifth studio album, and it was the second album produced by Daniel Lanois and Brian Eno. This is, to me, one of the greatest albums of all time. It is a perfect album. Every song is great on it. Every melody is great. The lyrics are great. It's one of those few records that I can point to that is like that. I mean, there's a number of them, and someday I'll do a series of videos on what I call perfect albums. But this song actually has a bunch of U2 elements combined, and it's only about 2 minutes and 54 seconds long. Now, U2 is a band that I've rarely talked about on this channel, but Bono is one of the greatest melody writers ever. And this song is a really great example of that. Let's take a look at the intro. When the song enters, it comes in on D major and goes to A minor. If we're thinking of G major, then this is the 5 chord to the 2 chord, which is actually kind of unusual, okay? Later on, it goes to E minor in the chorus. You could actually analyze it as if this is in E minor, too. So that would be the flat 7 chord to the 4 chord. But let's just stick with D mixolydian right now, because that's kind of what it sounds like. There's a harmonic part that goes between the 7th fret harmonic on the G string and D string. Let's check it out. And then, it's going from the F sharp, which is the 3rd of the D major chord, down to E, which is the 5th of the A minor chord. So you're going from one chord tone to the next. Okay, next I want to talk about the most underrated drummer in rock, Larry Mullen Jr. I'm a huge Larry Mullen Jr. fan. Let me tell you why. Larry Mullen is really the backbone of U2. His drumming, his time feel is so solid that it makes stadiums of people move. That is why U2 became a stadium band. They had the melodies, they had the grandiose, beautiful guitar, echo guitar parts that filled up stadiums, but if it wasn't for the pulse and Larry Mullen's time feel, people would never have gotten into U2. He is so steady. Now, what's interesting about this drum part from a production point of view is that you don't really hear the hi-hat. I think that they've actually muted the hi-hat and in its place have put the guitar, I think it's a 12-string guitar, acoustic guitar, that is actually doing the chicka 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 part and taking the place of the 16th notes on the hi-hat. But if you look at the live version from Rattle and Hum of U2 playing In God's Country, you'll notice that he is on the hi-hat playing 16th notes. Here is the pattern of the groove that he's playing. You'll also notice that Larry has a floor tom on his left and his right. And that enables him to do those dick-a-doo-da licks that he does on a lot of U2 songs. I think he initially put that there when he was playing Pride or In the Name of Love. The beat was based around having that, I believe it's a 16-inch floor tom. Same thing on both sides. But because of the sticking, he's able to hit that floor tom on the left and then come back and hit the floor tom on the right. And it actually flows better. And you'll see it. Let me show you the video again. You can see him hit that. So that is the pattern that he's playing there. Now, what I actually think happened is that he actually is playing that hi-hat pattern, and then Daniel Lanois, when he was mixing it, just muted it and leaned towards the acoustic guitar so there's no flamming of it. But that's really the drum pattern that's happening there. And that incessant kick part is what really drives the song. I also want to talk about the bass part. Adam Clayton, I think people give a bad rap to. They think, oh, because he doesn't do anything fancy. Well, he actually does do fancy things. He leaves space in the bass part. So what we have here, space. That is a great bass part. And that space leaves so much more room for the groove to happen. And that's one of the genius things about Adam Clayton, is that he leaves space all the time. A lot of his bass parts have a ton of space in them. Next, let's check out Bono's melody. There's a sky to Okay, that's a great phrase right there. We got, he's going from the second to the third of the D chord. Desert sky. And then he goes right up to the dreamed. He goes up to that dreamed a song. So he's going to A, he's making it an A minor seventh chord by singing that G. And then he goes back to the rivers run the right. Comes right down the scale. The rivers run, but soon run dry. He's going to the ninth to the root, or the second to the root. And then, we need new dreams tonight. Soon run dry, we need new dreams tonight. Perfect melody. The balance of the phrase, where it ends, need new dreams tonight, rest. Once again, space. The space in the melody is incredibly important. It gives the listener a chance to recover from what they've heard and actually think about what they've heard. So in the chorus, we go to E minor. Let's check it out. Sleep comes like a drug in God's good. So this is a chord tone melody. There's actually one non-chord tone in it. It's a perfectly balanced A-B-A-B melody. So it goes, sleep comes, and then, so there's that sixth on the G chord, but right to the fifth, and then to the root of the D, and then, in God's, to the third of the G, to the fifth of the D. Right? So, anytime you can make a chord melody out of it, it sounds, it's going to be a strong melody. And then, and then back in. So that sleep comes like a drug in God's country. It's great because there's that space. Sleep comes like a drug, space in God's country, space. Sad eyes, crooked crosses, space in God's country. And then you're on to the second verse. That's how you write a perfectly balanced chorus melody. So after the first chorus, we have the re-intro, okay? So. And then we're on to the second verse. I love that lyric, set me alight, you punch a hole right through the night. And then. Every day the dreamers die, see what's on the other side. Great, great lyric. She is liberty, and she comes to rescue me. Hope the second chorus. Sleep comes like a drug. Now in the second chorus, Adam Clayton actually goes to C. Sleep comes like a drug. Solo. Out of all the songs on Joshua Tree, it's interesting. I really like this song, but I never thought that it was fully realized sonically. Lyrically, I think it's great, but I think sonically, it's not fully realized. But this is the thing about U2, is that they were able to take songs and make them better live. They're one of the very few bands that I've seen that does better versions live. Almost every song on the Joshua Tree tour and the Achtung Baby tour, the band played or performed better than the album versions. I mean, it's really pretty incredible. And Bono's vocal performances, go to the Rattle and Hum movie, you know, watch any videos from U2 back in the late 80s, early 90s, and just spectacular performances all around. Every vocal take, I said it during the 20 Greatest Singer video, every vocal take of Bono's is worthy of being on an album. From me being a producer and hearing people do vocal takes, there's very few people that can come in and just nail it in one take. It's really, really rare. And he does it. This is all pre-Pro Tools, all that you know, when you watch Rattle and Hum and when you listen to the records, those are takes. They're not fixed or anything. I mean, maybe they do a punch in here or there, but when I saw them play live, he killed it every time. I've wanted to do a U2 song for a long time. I have no tracks, no multi-tracks of U2, no stems, no nothing. Never been able to find any. It's funny because they're a band that's done remixes and things like that. You think that they might be out there, but nowhere. This video may get taken down. I don't know. But I'd love to do a song in the future if I had the tracks because they are such a performance-based band that the takes... When Edge plays Where the Streets Have No Name, if you watch the making of the Joshua Tree and they play the multi-tracks on it, the left and right parts are played all the way through. They talked about taking 6 months to do it because it was really hard because it's in 6-4 time in the first part of the song. They had a chart that, you know, written on a chalkboard and things that they were trying to follow, and they would go for performances. U2 is a band that I really know a lot about, and I hope to be able to do another song in the future. That's all for now. Please subscribe here to my Everything Music YouTube channel. If you're interested in the Beato book, go to my website at www.rickbeato.com. And if you want to support the channel so that I can keep putting out content like this, think about joining the Beato Club. You can find out more about it on my website as well. Thanks for watching.